Hi, everyone. Welcome to another episode of OEM TV. I'm Eric Mills with Microsoft. I do Windows Server Marketing. And in this video, you're going to see a demo of Azure Backup from within Windows Server Essentials Edition. As you know, the Essentials Edition is for customers that have fewer than 25 users in their company. It's a very low-cost, high-value operating system, and it's a great operating system for your first server. Now, a lot of people need a backup solution for their server, and Azure Backup is a great solution for that. It's an off-site cloud backup that integrates directly with Windows Server Essentials Edition. And in this video, Ken will just show you a demo of what it looks like. He'll talk about what it is, why you might want to use it. He'll show you how to set it up. He'll walk you through signing in for the Azure account and configuring the backup vault within Azure and connecting to it from Windows Server Essentials Edition. So hope you enjoy the video. It's very easy to set up backup from within Windows Server Essentials. It's something that everyone should do, and this video will walk you step by step on setting that up. So hope you enjoy it. We'll see you next time on OEM TV.
This video focuses on demonstrating the integration of Windows Server 2016 Essentials with Microsoft Azure Backup. Microsoft Azure Backup helps protect critical business information by encrypting your data and storing it in a secure and remote location that is accessible to you over the internet. In the event of data loss, you can use Microsoft Azure Backup to recover your files and folders by using a passphrase that is known only to you. For this demonstration, we are running Windows Server 2016 Essentials Edition in a virtual machine running on a local server. You also have the option of running Windows Server 2016 Essentials natively on a local server. For Windows Server Essentials integration with Microsoft Azure Backup, a Microsoft Azure 30-day trial or full subscription is required. To begin, I will enable the integration with Microsoft Azure Backup via a wizard in the Windows Server Essentials dashboard. The Server Essentials dashboard is part of Windows Server 2016 Essentials Edition and is automatically installed as part of the Windows installation and accessible via a shortcut on the desktop. So let's get started. From the home screen of the Windows Server Essentials dashboard, we're going to go over and click on Services. Then we're going to select Azure Backup. And then we're going to click on Integrate with Microsoft Azure Backup here on the right-hand side. It's actually now the wizard gets initiated and it starts downloading the Microsoft Azure Backup agent. Upon the completion of this, it will actually have the integration with Azure Backup and also creates another tab here in the dashboard. The wizard also helps us configure the server to use the Microsoft Azure Backup service. The first thing we need to do is sign into our Microsoft Azure account. Now, if you already have created an Azure subscription along with your Office 365 account, then just go ahead and sign in. Otherwise, you need to follow the links at the bottom here to sign up for a 30-day free trial or full subscription, and then return back here to sign up. Now, we already have an Azure account, so I'm just going to go and click on Sign In. I'll go ahead and enter my credentials and then click Sign In. I see my subscription here for my Azure account. I'm going to go ahead and name the backup vault on where our backups are going to be maintained, and we'll call it Backup 1 Vault. And then we're going to go ahead and select the region on where we want, and let's just pick here East US, and we'll click Next. It's now going ahead and creating our backup vault and registering the server. Now that it's registered, I can continue configuring my Azure backup by selecting the folders and files that I want backed up to the vault. So in this case here, we'll take all the defaults here and we're going to go ahead and click Next. It's now continuing to configure our server. Our server is now configured to back up our items to the Microsoft Azure Backup service. Backup data is encrypted to ensure full privacy and a passphrase has been automatically generated. This will be required to restore the backup data later on. Now let's click Close and we'll take a look at the Azure Backup features in the Essentials dashboard. So here we see the new tab that has been created called Azure Backup, and we can see over here on the right hand side the Azure Backup task. Reconfigure Azure Backup. We can actually start a backup now, restore files and folders, reset the passphrase that we have, and then also visit more information online to get about the Azure Backup. We can also disable this if we want to as well. You can also see the list of all the different backups that you have. We can look at what protected folders that we have scheduled for backup, and even look at our backup histories from previous backups as well. Now, Azure Backup is very cost-effective. You only pay for the data you use in the cloud, and it has pretty good compression. You can check out the Azure Backup pricing page for more details. By the way, there is no charge for downloading data from your backup vault for the purposes of restore. One note on limitations of this solution. This solution is for file and folder backup only. You cannot do a full server or system state backup using the dashboard integration or plugin. However, it would be possible to separately configure system state backups to a new server folder, probably on a separate virtual hard drive or volume, that is then included in the backup job for Azure. Let's take a look at some of more of the advanced configuration settings. If we click on Configure Azure Backup on the right-hand side here, and then we're going to click on Customize Azure Backup Policy, and then down here we're going to click on Advanced Configuration. From here you can see that we are only able to back up the server data as often as twice daily. And then if we look at under retention, we can see that we can retain backups for a maximum of 30 days. And then under bandwidth, on the upside, you also get some handy options for limiting the bandwidth usage during business hours. So you can see all the additional configuration here. Now it is possible to download and configure your own Azure Backup agent or use Microsoft Azure Backup Server to achieve even more control and expand your options for off-site backups. These are just the limitations of the backup plugin that is included with the Essentials integration. So this is just a quick overview of the new Azure Backup services for Windows Server Essentials. Thank you.